Integral Designs is a leading landscape company in India. We probably are the largest landscape company, and we've been honored to be invited to participate in designing this very prestigious project. We are based out of Delhi, and we've been working around the world and in India, and we are about 50 strong. So our way of life is about introducing nature into cities and making sure that services and all the other elements which are necessary for the functioning of human cities are integrated well, and people enjoy life as being one with nature. In this project, the challenges were manifold, but I think what has come about today is something which is spectacular. It will definitely be a masterpiece. It will definitely be the benchmark for the future for the projects in this region. The most important part about this project is its location. It's really well connected. And I'm not just saying that. I mean, I know that it is well connected. It takes me only 35 minutes from South Delhi to reach here. And so the location helps develop many other matters in terms of design. And our challenges were threefold. Landscape is often thought of as a visual experience. It's only about what you see, but not really about what you experience. It's not really about what is under the land. It's not about what is over the land. It's purely visual in most people's minds. Now, in this case, to achieve this sense of exclusivity, we felt that functional requirements such as parking, roads, where the drivers will stand, if there are sports facilities, how they are built, if there are water bodies, how well they are maintained, those are as important as the visual aspects. So we paid particular attention to making sure that the level of detail down to the smallest fine element has been taken care of. So the landscape now, instead of being purely visual, is now functionally sound. Another matter which almost everybody wants, and they say when we talk to them, and I'm sure everybody who sees this will be talking about it, is about nature, that we want to live next to nature. In cities, it's difficult. But here, what this idea of landscape means is that we are trying to introduce a heightened sense of nature into this project. Now, how do you do heightened sense of nature? The requirements of parking means that there are basements, there are approach roads, there's a lot of paved surfaces. So we would like, and we've been proposing this and it has been accepted, and that's what is being built, that we would like the greens to dominate. We would also like the parameters for judging whether nature is successfully implemented in a project. There are rating systems already in place. So we are attempting to achieve the highest level of rating for introduction of greens into any project. So that was the first part of the challenge. And when you look at it in a holistic way, we've assumed that the parking and the regular requirements, walkways, security will be taken care of. They will be unobtrusive. They will not occupy space. We want to achieve this sense of calmness, a sense of being at ease with nature. And we also want no sort of intrusion of the city life into this living environment. So I think that's what we've been able to achieve till now. Landscape is about many things, but it's known often for horticulture. But horticulture is not all of landscape. Landscape is primarily to do with the holistic and overall environmental quality. That starts with the civil works, what lies underneath, the roads, walkways, bridges, water bodies, these are all part of the civil works experience. These are all part of the civil experience, and they will be what you will see day to day. Second part of landscape is lighting. That, yes, during the day gardens look fantastic, but they have to look equally nice in the evening, at night, so that you can use the garden practically anytime, whether it's early morning and it's still dark, or whether it's late night and you want to take a stroll after dinner, you should be able to use the landscape, which means landscape lighting will play a major role. The third thing in landscape is about art, artworks, about special features and elements. Now, who does not want to walk next to a water body? Who does not want to see nice sculptures? Who does not want a very interesting bench to sit on? So all these become what are landscape elements as special features. And we've been able to introduce almost all of this in this project at a very high level of precision. The fourth thing about landscape is that we want to return many things to nature. We don't want to overconsume energy in doing landscape lighting. We do not want to use water and not be able to recharge the groundwater table. So often we put in a lot of effort in making sure that landscape elements such as rainwater harvesting devices, such as solar panels, are all incorporated in the project as part of the landscape. So that was four. Now part five, and the most important part, is horticulture. Horticulture is about plants, it's about lawns, it's about shrubs, ground covers, climbers, trees. And you'll notice that when you look around, the best environments that come to mind are the ones which are shaded with trees. Greenery plays a major role in changing the way that you feel about your environment. So we've tried to address this idea. We've tried to make sure that most of the areas are as green as is humanly possible.